I would say if you're doing the California or Nevada BDRs, don't bother staying in Prim. It ain't worth it. The only reason I'm kind of glad that I stayed here is because it got below freezing last night. I don't know where I would have gotten to, but I would have rather stayed just about anywhere else. And that's all I'm gonna say about that. Alright, we are gonna try Coliseum Mine Road. It's supposed to be kind of gnarly, but somebody did the California BDR a couple of days ago. And according to them, the easy alternate road was actually in worse shape. Today's going to be interesting. I don't really know how today's going to go. I know that I can get to Furnace Creek. What I don't know is what is open beyond then. And I think from then until basically Lone Pine, I'm going to have significant diversions off of the route because basically nothing's open.
A few moments later.
And I have still not seen a soul out here. All right, let's do this thing. And this is the easy alternate, because I don't know what that turns into, but my recollection of the video is that there's deep sand, and I have no idea what the water near the job looks like. Yeah, that road over there just ceases to exist. Whereas this is in okay shape. It clearly still had some water down it though. Yeah, that road just ends. This is the easy route. How messed up is the regular route? Speed limit 80. It's actually 30. They just slightly modified it. That's funny. Speed limit as fast as you're willing to pay for. Ah, tinnitus. What would I do without you? Sorry, part of my disability rating for the VA is due to tinnitus, and it kicked in really hardcore right there for some reason. Like, ah, military grade tinnitus.
Later.
This is in Copa, right by the post office, and that was fantastic.
might actually turn around, because I don't want to burn my clutch out trying to get through this dune. I mean, look at that, like, I'm just digging a hole. I may literally just dip the bike over and flip it around. I'm gonna spin it. And then pick it back up. Okay.
Okay, whew. Now we're just trying to get out of here. These are the Ibex dunes, and they're really, really bad right now. I don't know what they're normally like, but I would say twice as bad as Sunset Crater on the Arizona BDR. So we're just gonna go nice and easy until I get back to where it's solid. I have no idea how far that goes for. I mean, it could go for 10 miles, it could go for a mile. I have no idea. Took the jacket off because I was roasting. It says it's 73, which is probably about right. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to get back out to the pavement, put into Google Maps Furnace Creek, and follow it. Alright, here was the turn where it had a mile and a half ahead, deep sand, which, I'm not kidding. Here first. Okay, let's see. Nope, it dead ends. So Furnace Creek is actually over there. And so basically what my route was going to do was go around those, well, through the dunes and then go around that range of mountains and hook back to the right and go back up one of these other valleys. But if I want to just take the pavement, I go back and go left and continue to Furnace Creek. Really quickly turned into something I wanted no part of.
August when it happened, so it's like, why were you in the park?
Few moments later.
Google's a little screwed up right now because it thinks the road is closed still. The indications that I've seen show that 190 is open all the way to Lone Pine. Should be about 100-ish miles. And I would imagine my camera will die at some point, but I'm not too worried about that. And either I'll get to Lone Pine tonight, or I will camp somewhere.
Negative 237 feet. How low can you go? How low can you go?